Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you that needed diagnostics for your car guys that can pay itself off in one time use, and that diagnostic guys can access every computer system, read codes, delete codes and see live data in every computer system in your car. So we're going to guys make a product review video for AutoMaster Pro CG680 Pro guys. This is amazing scanner that we'll definitely recommend. Stay with us and we'll put it to the test on a Volkswagen and a Fiat, even import vehicles, to see how powerful that tool is and how it can pay itself off in one time use instead of going to the dealer. Now that tool is for everybody that has a car or you're working on cars. Okay, it's a must have tool. Before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage guys, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. We take them completely apart, we show you how to fix pretty much anything. Why? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. If you need to check the scanner, see where you can get it from and more about it, I'll put the link in the description of the video below, so please check it out. Now this is it. You can see this is the scanner right here with the box. Really nice case, by the way. It comes with a USB cable, manual. This is an old system scanner guys. Okay, it's an old system scanner with specific functions. Those specific functions include like oil reset, DPF, total position warning, steering angle reset, the TPMS reset, multiple functions guys. And what I like about it, lifetime free update, let you always have the latest software. So this Volkswagen now, okay, it has the engine light on. Okay, and we're going to put it to the test. We'll scan the whole system and we'll see what it does. This is where your memory card is located. That's for the memory for updates and stuff like that, and that's where you connect the USB port. So the cable is connected. Let me go ahead, I'll go inside that Volkswagen Tiguan 2014 model and let's see, okay, what it does now. So we need to find the OBD port somewhere. Who knows where it is on that car? Okay, let me turn the light on. Okay, right underneath. It's a very low mileage car. It has only about 43,000 miles. Okay, let me get in. And let's put it to the test. I'm going to go ahead, turn the ignition on. Okay, let me just open the door to pull the cable a little bit. Okay, perfect. Now I'm gonna close it. We'll turn the radio off. Perfect. Now the scanner practically did turn on immediately. Okay, you can see. And let's explain what it has now. It has the auto VIN detection, which is super convenient because it reads the VIN number, decodes it and tell you which vehicle you have, so you don't have to manually do that. It has the OBD generic function to read OBD codes. It has diagnostics right here, maintenance, settings, data manager and update. Under diagnostics, you have American, Asian, you can see, or Europe vehicle as well. And it's going to, okay, you can select vehicles manually that way as well. You can see all the vehicles right here. So I'll go back now and I want to show you under maintenance. Okay, you have multiple things here, such as AFR adaptation, replace airbag and computer, ABS service, change the tire size. Let's say you switch to different tire size, we have winter tires or summer tires. Okay, you can do that. Now it does not support all the vehicles for the tire size, but you can still do it in the programming on Volkswagen through the diagnostics, I believe. Now you can see DPF, headlamp reset, injector reset, odometer, oil reset. Oil reset is the one that you will use the most, and here you just select the vehicle that you need. You scroll down, you find it. Okay, Volkswagen will be supported here, and you reset it, which is even Lamborghini, Ferraris, all that. They all reset it, I think it's for every single car. So right here, Volkswagen. Now, let's talk about a steering angle sensor. That's the most common function that you will use, because sometimes you remove, replace the battery, you have the traction control light on. Let's say you did a phone and alignment, you will need to guys actually reset the steering angle sensor. Okay, another, otherwise it's not going to work correctly. You have traction and ABS light on, which is terrible. So if you go to Volkswagen right here, okay, steering wheel electronics, brake electronics, steering assistance. So there are three modules that you can access for that specific function. And It tells you how you can reset it practically. Okay, it teaches you all that stuff for each one of those vehicles, which is super, by the way, super convenient. So this is a function that you definitely guys need to use quite often. Now, you need to check the manual, the website. Some of those are not, the special functions are not for every single vehicle, but if you go to the diagnostics, you can access every single computer in your car. You can see it's going to read the VIN number. And you can read the LEED codes and see live data, guys, okay, with absolutely no problem. It's Volkswagen Europe, it's not China. We select here, login data, please, Wayne. Okay, that's what's going to do now. Tiguan after 2008, ours is 2014. Right there, the US Tiguan, perfect. And now, you can go to diagnostics. You can do quick scan or control module. Quick scan, guys, it's going to scan the whole system. Control modules, you can select only, let's say, the engine computer here now. And you can read what's wrong. Because when I start this vehicle, I want to show you something. When I start it, the engine light stays on. Okay, you can see engine light stays on. So what we're going to do now, I'm going to go ahead, okay, and read the codes and see what is there actually. And okay, let's see now. Please wait, loading data. Okay, it's reading the engine computer now, communicating with it, and it will tell us, okay, exactly what code we have. Passive, occasional, EVAP emission control valve system detected. There is a small EVAP leak somewhere in the system, and that's why the light turned on. That could be loose fuel cap, it could be broken seal on the fuel cap, it could be an EVAP line that has a crack in it. So, I want to show you how you can see, okay, you can actually even see the freeze frame. That's when it occurred. It occurred at 69,000 kilometers. That's the time that it occurred. Okay, and at what RPMs, 1167 RPMs, the load of the engine was 20%, temperature of the coolant was 74 and outside was 24 degrees Celsius. It shows you all that stuff which can analyze what causing that code. You can clear it, okay, you can delete the code if you want to, okay, you select yes, yes, okay. Deleted it. You can see, guys, the engine computer information here if you need it, such as part number, soft coding, okay, all that stuff is right here, which is very helpful if you need to replace it or check the coding software version and all that stuff. Now you can go to live data, and under live data you can see almost everything you can think of for your engine computer and your car, guys. You can check multiple things, okay, input channel number or custom list. Okay, let's go to custom. I believe it was under custom list. We can select all of it, and you can see, okay, select all, perfect. And now if I start that engine, guys, okay, if I start that engine, I can read everything about it. Coolant temperature 36 degrees Celsius, RPMs 1160, okay, right here you can see. Now, engine load, you can open graph, let's say for the RPMs, I'm going to rev the engine up and I want to show you the graph, guys, okay, how it goes up. Okay, and you can see what we have here. It goes up, down, up. You can see how responsive it is. So you can test everything, guys. You can test your brake switch, injection timing. All that is right here, okay? It tells you everything about that. Mass airflow sensor, something super important, by the way. Mass airflow sensor is how much air it uses the engine. It says 3.6 grams per second. And if I have the engine up, okay, it should go up. Okay, check it out. Up to like 88. So if I rev it up a little bit slowly, it should go gradually up, then all of a sudden up, down if I let go. So that's how much air the engine is using. So you can test practically the mass airflow sensor. You can see throttle valve angle, all that stuff, guys, is there. Ignition timing. You can do, actually, you can see the, let me focus quick. That's the voltage for the alternator, and you can see your oxygen sensor as well here, okay? Let me just find them. Oxygen sensors you can find and see, okay, right here. has so many things that you can read. It has probably more than 200 parameters. Okay, watch now where we are on the screen, and you can scroll all the way down. Okay, so there is quite a few things that you can check for each one of those, okay, and for different channels. Volkswagen, Audi, they have a specific system, but it makes it, okay, really convenient. So you can go back. I want to show you if you order in the input channel number, and you can, if you know your Volkswagen really good, the different channels mean different things. Now, if I go ahead, go back, turn the car off, turn the ignition back on, you can actually see all the computers that are in that Volkswagen and all the different systems. Check it out. That's unbelievable, guys, how many it is. So there is practically like endless. That's how complicated vehicles are nowadays. So I can go back, we can do a quick scan. It's going to scan the whole system, by the way. Okay, select all computers, F34, okay, to confirm. It's scanning all 60 computers that might be equipped with, depending on the option package. It's going to scan each one of those. It's going to give us, okay, if we have fault codes or we don't. So once the scan is done, okay, I will continue and show you what the results are. But you can see engine, now we deleted the code, we didn't have the engine light on, and there is pass, no fault codes. Transmission doesn't have fault codes as well, and you just keep doing that for a little bit. So it is towards the end, 59 out of 60 channels, guys, that it scanned all. Okay, let me focus quick here. We have quite a few codes in the system. You can see the report if you want to. Okay, it's done. You can see F3, it's the report, and it's going to tell you how many problems you have and all that stuff. Or you can go, okay, specifically and find out what's wrong with the systems. Okay, for instance, we have in the central electrical system one code. Okay, you can read it. Let me show you now. Just quick, it accessed the system. We're going to click read codes. You can see, you can clear the codes, read codes, see live data. Quite helpful information. Active static, luggage compartment light. Okay, open or short. So problems with the trunk light, guys. Okay. And you can check each one of those, and you can actually, what you can do, once you do all that stuff, you can actually click F1 to erase. Okay, everything, it's just reading the codes now. We click F1 erase, and you can erase all the systems in that Volkswagen, guys, and make sure that you don't have any faulty codes. So that's what it's doing now. And let me go ahead and show you how, okay, it works on Fiat as well, exactly the same way, guys. Okay, exactly the same thing on the Fiat. Probably we'll have airbag codes because we have problems with the airbag light turning on and off, like all of a sudden, like you hit a bump, there is a loose connection somewhere. So we'll see, okay, what it tells us about that. Hopefully we will find out. So this is the last code that it's clearing now. Okay, and we're practically, guys, okay, ready, so we can exit. So let's go ahead and we're going to test it on the Fiat now. So now we're going to test the computer on that baby Ferrari, also known as Fiat Abarth, guys. They call it the baby Ferrari. As you know, the Fiat Abarth is known as a baby Ferrari. So Ferrari is actually owned by Fiat, so practically, okay. let's say the same thing. It makes us feel better that we have one, right? Maybe one of these days. So we're going to go ahead, plug it in. Okay, and let's see now on that Fiat. Okay, it has the CAN system as well, which is a pain, okay, to do that, no sticks on that stuff. So I'm going to turn the, okay, I'm going to turn the heater radio off. Now we're going to click out of in here. It's plugged in, out of in, automatic VIN acquisition. It's going to, on the Volkswagen it was super quick. On some cars it takes a little bit longer to read, depending on which system they have, which is pretty quick still. This is the VIN number, and we have America, Chrysler, or Europe, Fiat. Now, that Chrysler Corporation builds Fiat now, so we'll go with Chrysler for this one, okay, but if we have problems, we'll connect to the European Fiat, because actually this one is made probably in Mexico, I don't know where it is, but it's not in Europe. This is the American version. Failed code. Okay, so we need to go to actually, okay, let's go back to SmartVIN. Again, it's going to read in. Oh, my bad. I need to go out. So here now, it gives us after 2007, that's where the Fiat 500 is. We need to select this one. Fiats have absolutely different system, guys. We need to find our Fiat 500 only. That's 500L, that's a big Fiat, big brother. And ours is 2015 model. You can do quick scan or control modules. If we do a quick scan, it's going to do the same that we did on the Volkswagen, but it doesn't have so many computers. It's going to scan quickly. It's going to tell us practically what we have. Fault code 1 in the engine computer, you can see. This Fiat, it's very little, doesn't have so much electronics. Practically, it's the, you know, the Abarth, which is the high performance edition, but Fiats are pretty actually pretty lean on the electronics, so that's a good thing. But we have problems everywhere, and I believe we have a loose ground wire because we have multiple codes. Okay, multiple codes because of that, and you can see 6, 8, 1, 4, quite a few codes that are in that system. So if we actually go ahead and check them, okay, that's the last one that's reading. We can check, okay, PCM power control module. Let me see, where is the airbag module? Okay, that's where our problem is. That really irritates me because I'll be driving down the road and all of a sudden airbag light will be on the dash. Okay, and then it will go away. It said stored can be bus. Okay, you see, that's communication with the bus module, guys. And U001988, that's the code. You can see the freeze frame, and when it occurred, it's going to show you all that. Okay, test failed, okay, all that stuff. You can see the different parameters, okay, and why it was on. So if I go to IPC, which is the instrument panel cluster, we have quite a few problems there as well. That's why I think that we're losing ground on this car, to be honest with you, because all of a sudden you get the codes. So there is probably lost communication. Lost communication with the computers. So if it loses communication, probably we have a loose ground wire or corroded ground wire that actually does that. And as a result, guys, okay, that will store multiple codes in the system. And with the help of that computer, you can see with the loss of communication, we can find out, okay, that this is the problem. And you can go to body control module. Probably we'll still have loss of communication codes there as well. Let me check it quick. Okay, see what it's going to say there and see if we can take care of that problem now. Okay, yep, general electrical failure, signal possibility failure, loss of communication. So we have a loose ground wire somewhere, guys. You can see that computer can teach you so much. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.